President, this is Deborah Fitterer. I'll be right outside.
It's Fitterer?
Fiddler. Fitterer. It's Fitterer.
I saw your resume, so we don't need to talk about that. What have you been doing recently?
I'm an alpaca farmer.
Like the sweaters?
Before their sweaters.
Uh-huh. And before that?
Craps and blackjack.
You're a professional gambler.
I like the way that sounds.
Whereabouts?
Bally's, mostly.
Okay. Why did you leave the White House?
Well, Mr. President, if you want to talk about getting screwed with your pants on...
Charlie!
I guess I got pretty well doinked.
Yes, sir.
Can I have a minute?
Yes, sir.
Would you mind waiting outside just a moment?
No, not at all.
Is this a joke? If it's a joke, it's both funny and well executed. But I think you and I both know that it's not.
I don't know what that means.
You can keep the job.
Great. Why?
Why? Because you knocked me out, that's why.
How did I do that?
Let's stick some arsenic in President Bartlett's drinking water and see if he delegates responsibility to the World Bank then. President Bartlett, you refer to me and to the office with respect. Your class act.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Whack job.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, one of my seats like a baby.
Well, first of all, that's not a cow. It's not. It's a goat. Yeah, I may have agreed to something about a goat.
What, did the first lady get you drunk and take you shopping?
Leo, yes. The name of the group is Heifer International. I was under the impression it was going to be a cow.
Lending presidential aura to the photo?
Okay. I think what we're going to do is, I think we're going to wait until after the vote at 10:30, because if we don't win, then it'd be a mistake for this picture to run tomorrow.
How big a mistake?
One from which certainly my job would have hung in the balance.
In the balance?
Goats are heifers, too?
I don't know.
If the president's wearing a hat, or that thing's wearing a Bartlett button, I'm hiding snakes in your car.
Come on, don't say that. Not even to joke.
You're never going to know where they are,
Leo!
Or if you got them all out. Excuse me. Gonna lay their eggs right in the glove compartment.
So, this is gonna be a little while. Can you wait?
Well, Ron doesn't do that well in the cold.
Are you Ron?
I'm Mike.
Of course. We'll find an empty room for him.
I have oats in the truck.
Well, you should bring the oats, because the mess closes at 6.
Okay. Hello.
Day.
Mr. Danforth.
Tough beat, everybody. Thanks for the work. Next time, we let Josh do it the way he wants.
Sir, have you met...
Bill Haley.
Will Bailey.
Okay.
Good evening, Mr. President.
What's this thing with the cow?
It's a goat now.
Okay.
We'll cancel it.
You think?
A milking goat? It's gonna seem like a parody of foreign aid.
I don't know. I don't know, everybody. CJ wants to cancel the goat picture. Half the world's people live on less than $2 a day. 130 million will never step inside a schoolhouse. Ingredients for bombs can be purchased at hardware stores. And we've just given the third world just what the doctor ordered, Rovax. Heifer International, they give free cows and goats to people who need milk.
Yes, sir.
Well, then I don't think we're in any position to be snotty. Let's do it. Let's do it right now.
Carol?
They're right out here.
So I think... this will work. I think it says, well, you're impoverished, and while we don't care, we don't want you to go away empty-handed, so we offer this goat, Ron, to give you milk.
Do male goats give milk?
No. No, of course they don't. So we offer you this thing that'll just gnaw on your stuff.
I'm not standing in this picture alone. This was a total team failure. Stand where you want. But I want my chief of staff and my chief political advisor standing near the goat. Let's go!
Hang on a second. Okay. Thank
you. Now,
we're ready.
Let's go.
Set that clock for 90 days.
called The Theory of Everything.
The Theory of Everything?
Yes.
Is it comprehensive?
CJ.
That was a joke there, pal of mine.
I want you to lead with this.
Carol, I'm missing the OMB stats.
They're coming.
CJ, I want you to lead with this.
I'm not going
to
lead with it.
Yes, you are.
Okay.
So you got it?
Sure.
I mean, you got what you're supposed
Carol,
to say?
Carol, also the EPA? The
committee won't be out till 3.
CJ, say it for
He's
me.
He's making me crazy.
You know, I heard that.
Yeah, I understand how a speakerphone works.
Say it for me.
Joshua, I really have to get to the
say
briefing
it,
room.
Say it, please.
Psychics at Caltech and the Fermi National Accelerator Lab are close to announcing what
Physicists.
Looks like...
Theoretical physicists at Caltech.
Not psychics?
No.
I should jot that down.
Please.
I'll tell you, if it was psychics, I'd lead with it.
CJ.
Talk to you later, Mia Moore.
I don't think you understand.
Thank you. You can sit him down. Sam, let Josh rant a little before you hang up the phone.
Sure.
CJ?
Yes, ma'am.
The Bureau of Labor Statistics is going to report that the CPI jumped 0.7%.
Okay.
It's the biggest one-month increase since the Bureau began tracking prices in 52.
All right, let me say this. The market basket used to calculate the CPI is antiquated.
Say outdated.
And doesn't include some regular household items.
Yes.
Like computers.
The prices are always dropping.
Yes.
And doesn't reflect significant technical improvements like airbags in automobiles, which increase the price of the car very slightly, but provide a much greater value to the consumer. You've got all that?
Let's find out.
CJ.
Leopold.
Mention the HUD secretary's announcing changes in the underwriting criteria for the Federal Housing Administration.
Well, the network's going to want to break in with special coverage for that.
The adjustments are in FHA-related lending.
Seriously, they're going to need time to put together a logo and theme music.
You know, the Bureau of Labor Statistics reported
the CPI jump by 0.7%.
Thank you.
CJ? Oh, wholly interrupt us, Batman.
Grant Samuels died.
Really?
Yes.
He's really dead this time?
Yeah.
Because last time you told me he was dead, he wasn't.
He's dead this time.
Somebody poked him a little to see
He died, CJ.
Well, okay, then I shouldn't have made a joke.
I'm almost certain he's dead.
Sam?
I was making a joke, too.
Why,
you work alone? He's survived by his wife, Eileen, son, Robert, his two daughters, Priscilla and Patty, and 8 grandchildren.
I'm not going to learn their names.
That's fine.
Eileen, Robert, Priscilla, Patty, 8 grandchildren. I'm assuming it was complications due to...
Yeah.
You know anything about theoretical physics?
Ah, the grand unified theory.
You know anything about it?
No.
Okay.
Folks, please take your seats. The briefing will start now.
Good morning, everybody. I have to start with a sad announcement. Congressman Grant Samuels finally succumbed to pneumonia last night. His wife, Eileen, his son, Robert, his daughters, Priscilla and Patty, and his 8 grandchildren are all in the president's thoughts today. I also want to talk this morning about the Bureau of Labor Statistics and the Federal Housing Administration. And as a special treat for our friend Josh Lyman, who's recovering very nicely at GW, the president's science advisor is telling us that psychics at Caltech and the Fermi National Accelerator Lab. You know what? I'm pretty sure that was supposed to be physicists.